Welcome back to Beyond Words. I'm Mark Hart. Here we are, back in ordinary time. And you might think to yourself, is that really that big a difference? I mean, really, this year, I mean, the time between Advent and Lent, extraordinarily short. But here we do have a few weeks of ordinary time. And as we start back in ordinary time, time is of the essence. In this famous episode from St. John's Gospel, the mother of Jesus, Mary, is going to have a request for her son. It seems that she's found herself at this wedding, not only she, but her son and some of his friends. Yet the wedding people have a problem. This reception has run dry, and it's run dry early. And now the bride and bridegroom are going to be very embarrassed because they don't have enough wine for their guests. And in the Mediterranean culture, hospitality is everything. So to run short of wine is really more than what we would call embarrassing in our culture. It's something you don't do. It would be a tremendous embarrassment, not only to the bride and groom, but to their whole family. And when Mary goes to Jesus with a seemingly insignificant request, we hear him say something very interesting to his mother. And he says, woman, he's trying to refer back to the literature of Genesis with the old Adam, the old Eve. Well, here's the new Adam, Jesus, and the new Eve, Mary. And when he looks at her and says, woman, how does this concern me? My hour's not yet come. The timeless one, God, who has entered time through Jesus, is now going to make a commentary about time. And this is the appointed time. This is going to be the first public miracle that Jesus is going to work. And he does it at the request of his mother. Now, as Catholics, we understand how this works because we go to Mary for intercession. We ask for her to pray with us and to pray for us now and at the hour of our death. And as Jesus heeds the request of his mother, as a good Jewish boy would, because we're all told to honor our father and our mother, the first miracle is wrought through his hands, and the water becomes wine. This is a great lesson on many levels. First, that God's always going to give us what we need, not always just what we want. But that God also honors the requests and the intercession of his mother, because he thinks that highly of her. She is the Immaculate Conception. And we also have to remember that there's a time for everything, as it says in Ecclesiastes. And this was when the time was right. The appointed time had come in the mind of God. And my brothers and my sisters, we go to God with many requests, as Mary did. We ask Mary to pray with us on many requests. And we have to trust, like she did, that God will respond in the right way when the right time comes. And when the right time comes, I'll tell you what, it's going to be even better than we imagined, just as the wine was even better than they had imagined. Entrust your prayers to God and take a lesson from Mary. Trust in His perfect timing and watch the miracles flow.